Again, and yes, that's right, that is the Grand Danse Bridge right there. I'm sure it has a better, more official name, but that's what I know it as. The Jeremie Bridge that takes you into the city that we're about to feature this episode. I am so extremely excited to be here, one of the major cities in Haiti, one of the hearts of this department. It's the capital center of the Grand Danse department. There's so much history here, so much we have to show you. I hope we get enough in before we run into an hour or 2 hours, but it won't be that long. We're gonna get some of the cooler aspects of Jeremie, and we're gonna bring it to you. We're gonna show it to you. And this isn't where we're gonna stop it. We got a series that we're gonna have here. So make sure you subscribe to the channel, hit that red button, hit that like button. We're gonna get started. Jeremie has so much to offer, and we're gonna be showing it to you in this series. Let's go. So in front of us here is the Jeremie Airport. Jeremie Airport is recently renovated. As you can see, it has a reception area. I mean, it's more of a regional airport, but certainly one of the first times we had an airport that here in Jeremie that can full time take, you know, relatively large carriers into the city. Folks tell me it's been a boost to the local area, the economy. It's helped certainly a lot of folks with some of the turbulence that's been happening just outside of Port-au-Prince to be able to get on a plane and get over here guaranteed. And I can tell you, if I'm ever traveling and coming to Jeremie, believe me, I have one way I'm gonna commute, and that is through the air, because literally you can get here in 30 minutes, right? I mean, that might be exaggerating, might be 15, 30 minutes versus driving. It took me 9 hours to get here because of traffic and other stuff. So without it, so no brainer, if you're coming to Jeremie, get on a plane. I'm in Jeremie's central place, Place du Mas, in front of a church, Saint Louis. And this place is really a epicenter, really, of the history that's happened here in Jeremie. Jeremie, as you know, is a very unique history. For example, it was, I don't know if you know this, but for a long time, the English was based out here. And that's one reason why during the Revolution, you should know that, we were able to beat the English, the French, and the Spanish. And the base of the English during the Revolution was here in Jeremie, right? And so it has a very unique sort of English flavor to it, a little bit. But here, still here, there is a very uniqueness of Jeremie. Specifically, they say that, listen, if a president wants to go, if a president is gonna go, they just gotta piss off, you know, Jeremie. They just gotta get the city of Jeremie up, and they're out, and they're gone. There's a saying, for example, happy wife, happy life in Haiti, happy Jeremie, happy nation. Right? So again, I really encourage you guys. This place is so laid back. I'm able to just be out here, chill, relax, enjoy vibes. I encourage you guys to be out here as well when you come out here to visit, you know, because again, that's what's so cool about anywhere else that isn't Port-au-Prince. You can just enjoy and be totally carefree. So where are we right now? We are in front of the Place des Poètes. And one thing that you have to know about Jeremie, Jeremie is known as the city of writers. Jeremie is known as the city of poets. It has per capita the most well-regarded and well-renowned in Haiti, international writers and poets the country has produced, right? Usually the first thing you think of when you think about Jeremie is well-educated, well-versed with words, people, right? And this monument here that we're in front of is honoring three of really the most well-known. We have Emile Romer, we have Edzard Villar, and we got Jean F. Brier as honorees, but there's so many of them. The list of writers go on and on here in Jeremie. That's one of the things that makes me so fond of Jeremie, is that they put themselves out in a renaissance and avant-garde sort of way, right? Found ourselves in Mark's Mart, and after a long day of moving around the city, it's great to know that, listen, I have all the comforts of what I'm used to here in Jeremie. And it was so cool, is this place only recently opened. It opened earlier this year around January, and it's founded by a Jeremian that's doing some great stuff here. So hats off to someone who's, you know, anyone, of course, who decides to hit the pavement and invest and do great things in this country. And again, it's always a good thing to feed the people. So good to have it. And while shopping, I ran into someone who was doing some awesome things here in Jeremie. Come on in the shot.
Hey,
Wilmar, Creole Explorer here. Doing,
nice to meet you, SeeJeanty.
Thank you.
Hi,
and remember, the big thing of this episode is that we're trying to not only show the awesome of the city, but also the people who are doing some awesome stuff. And Wilmar is doing some fantastic things on her IG page. And so what's so cool about your page is that you I think a big part of what you do is food. The food of Jeremie and Haiti, but since you're in Jeremie for a little bit, it's been the different things that happened in Jeremie. So that's, is that a good summary of?
Creole Explorer? Yeah, I guess let me just give you a little bit of context behind my page. So it did start as a food blog in 2014. So I was only blogging about showing pictures about the food that I was cooking while I was in college. Then that kind of stopped after I volunteered a little bit in Ethiopia, and I didn't really have good internet, so it kind of broke off. When I moved back to Haiti and I started working in the provinces and different departments, and definitely not in Port-au-Prince, I started like seeing things that I wasn't used to, because I would go on vacation when I was younger in the United States, not really in the province. So everything amazed me, like when I started working. So I wanted to share that with people on my Instagram. And I also wanted to share that with people on my Instagram, wanted to share it with my friends, with family, with people that are out living outside of Haiti, especially Haitian Americans. Because I feel like they can definitely come back to Haiti and live and build something. We need people. So that's really the whole goal of Creole Explorer. Just, I want one person to just see how I'm living, how other people are living, to see that it's possible to live in Haiti and to move back and contribute to our society. I know it's hard now.
Yeah.
It can be hard now, especially in the times that we're living at and like in the context.
It's ebbs and flows, but we got to keep pushing. Got to be consistent, right?
Yes, we have to try. Yes, we have
for
to
sure,
try.
For sure, for
yes.
sure. So now I think we're gonna cut to, you're gonna take us to someplace, because we can't have the Creole expert of food and a bunch of other stuff and not have her take us somewhere. So we're gonna go?
Yeah, we're gonna go to Adjuns.
Let's go. Here. So we found ourselves in Le Soleil, and we are about to chow down on some true typical food, Haitian food. We got some poulet here, we got some cabrit over there, we got some ragu on the side, and we have just everything. There's some fish, everything is here. It's a very nice day afternoon restaurant spot, real quiet, real laid back. And we ran into some genuine social media personalities here in the commune of Jeremie. Right next to me, I have Lucna. Lucna, how are you?
Hi.
Lucna is someone who's doing some incredible things in the commune area. She has...
Lucna, go ahead. Tell them what you're doing.
Moi, mon c'est Lucna. Moi, c'est un monde qui est dans le département de Grandance qui a fait promotion pour entrepreneuriat, technologie, leadership, avec santé. Et moi, c'est fondatrice comparée, qui est une entreprise sociale qui est dans le domaine entrepreneuriat, leadership. Peut-être que nous faisons formation et des programmes sur l'entrepreneuriat pour nous aider les gens qui sont dans le département de Grandance à grandir. Et moi, c'est responsable projet BIM, qui est une structure qui est dans le domaine médical. Côté que, ensemble avec la population, nous avons des gens qui sont capables d'aider pour améliorer la santé. Alors, moi, je suis avec vous.
Nice. So definitely, we're going to have her social media and info so you can follow her, do some great things. In fact, walking around with her, everyone knows her. Everyone, hey, how you doing, Lucna? So I was very happy to have her with her. And I got one more special person. Right next to us too, we have someone else here. We got Kerry. He's chowing his face down, hungry. Look at him, eating. And he's with Paradis Grandas. And he has his own social media channel. His information is gonna be below. And he's been like our guide, helping us, you know, commute around Jeremie and getting to know it. And again, a big thing about this series is really connecting with folks on the ground who are already doing what SeeJeanty is doing. We're getting the info out. So again, if you like what SeeJeanty, what we got going on with SeeJeanty, follow me and then follow these guys. They're fantastic. Kerry, how are you?
Yeah, so nous en forme. Et je vous dis, c'est un plaisir pour que nous ici dans le département de l'instant. Nous vraiment content et nous vous garantissons, amis, par nous. So
it's too late. I'm in love with Grandas. I don't want to go. He's right. So Kerry, thank you so much. What's your favorite thing about, what's the number one thing people don't know about Jeremie? And then you enjoy just amazing them.
For Jeremie, so you know bagay ki vraiment bon dans Jeremie, son bagay ki les biscuits. So son poisson. Que pas pour le droit de venir dans notre département. Pour que je venais, mais Jeremie, son poisson, spécialement les biscuits. Après ça, une spécialité dans ces tom-tom.
Ok,
tom-tom, son bagage comme ça. Après ça, on connaît Jeremie, son côté qui plérifié et qui a une belle lame et tout. Son département qui est riche. Qui est riche. D'ailleurs, nous avons une assiette qui est vraiment belle. Nous avons une belle toute qualité. Parce que là, en termes de végétation, nous avons une qualité pied-bois. Sur son bel département et moi garantis ça prépare mon séjour dans le département de son bagage pour pas bon
dieu. All right, and Kerry is showing all this on his social media all the time, so again, go follow him. I don't have Tom here, but I got some food that looks really good, so I'm gonna jump in and chow down, and we're gonna keep this show going. So what's going on here is they're making, this is what you call lumbi. This is where lumbi comes from. It comes from these shells. They're cutting it open, and this is going to be sold all across Jeremie and Pigeonville. So as you can see here, we have a boat being built, right? And these are the same boats, fishermen boats. And these boats, they go out in the water, they impact, you know, there's lumbi, they do a bunch of different stuff. And it starts right here. They take pieces of wood, and you can see they're working together as a team to get it done. It's really, really fascinating stuff. And this can take honestly months to complete. So we're seeing this midstream, they're not too far away, and pretty soon this bad boy is gonna be in the water. So where are we? Right now we are at the Gundas River. It's the intersection where the Gundas, which is a massive 22-mile river that connects to the Gulf of Guanab. This is literally where the magic happens, right? And you have a very strong, clean water current mixing with that fresh water current. And what's crazy is we have folks who traverse this. I mean, I'm looking at them, I'm like, yo, good luck to you. I ain't about that life. But this is truly one of the sights I just had to come and show you guys. It is truly a magical and powerful sight that's just literally right next to the main city of Jeremie. So we're here at Malibu Beach. It is a very, it's off the beaten path. So just so you can understand where we are, there's a small little village called Wozo on the way to Jeremie. There's a hard right that you have to make. You miss it if you don't know what you're doing. And it would take you straight here to this beach. And I can tell you, it is, when we're talking Caribbean, crystal clear waters. You look up that definition, you're gonna find this beach, or you should, you hear me? And this is only just an example of the many just fantastic, sandy, watery places that you can go while you're here in Jeremie. So anyways, I'm about to throw this off and get in this water, so y'all excuse me.
And guys, episode one is in the books. I want to thank you so much if you've gotten this far, if you've seen this much of Jeremie. Listen, I experienced it and I want more. So guess what? I'm gonna give more. We're just getting started. You're only seeing a fraction of this content. The beach, the people, the scenery. You're gonna get more in this series, so make sure you subscribe, hit that like button, share it to other people who are from the Jeremie area. Don't forget to follow Lucna and my boy Kerry. And guys, we'll be back at it again when we're back at it again. Peace.
And thanks to our supporter, Valerie Canez. When it comes to appliances, furniture, and living a quality life, there's no other place to shop than Valerie Canez. I've been a customer of theirs since I moved to Haiti. And when it comes to customer service, a great price, there's no other place in Haiti to shop. And here's a real cool thing you guys may not even know. You can be in the diaspora, you can be anywhere in the world, or you can purchase for friends and family anywhere you are without stepping foot in the store. You order online and they'll deliver wherever in Haiti. Listen, support us by supporting them. Thank you guys, and thank you, Valerie Canez.